Deep Landers of the World, welcome to this week's video. Today, we're going to be talking about 10 different camping subjects that encompass about 60 different tips. I'm sure you will find at least one or two that are new and useful to you. Also, stay all the way to the end because I am going to include a bonus subject that I think is very important for most people. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe if you can. Join us in our Deep Lander community. But let's not linger any longer here. It's going to be a long video jam-packed with information. Come with me to the camping grounds. It has been raining a lot lately around here, and it feels nice to be able to go out and about on a stroll for a change. Come along as we discuss these 10 camping tips that you may or may not have thought of. The first item that I want to cover today as part of these camping tips would be take simple care of your camping equipment. Things like removing the dirt that accumulates inside your sleeping bag before storing it, as well as your tent and even in the shaft of your trekking poles, is very important. You also might want to check the labels of your equipment for watching instructions. Due to new technology on the synthetic fabrics that we use for most of our equipment nowadays, it's very easy to watch almost everything. But for that very same reason, since everything is of a different nature, it becomes very important to check the labels. Another point would be to close all zippers and check all pockets of your items before watching. More than once I have made the mistake of watching little items like whistles or flashlights that I had stored in pockets of my equipment. It's not the end of the world, but it can help prevent having to replace expensive equipment in some instances. Here is one that I learned not too long ago. If you have a zipper that is constantly getting stuck, just apply some candle wax by rubbing a candle to it, and it will help lubricate it a little bit and make it easier to open and close. Also, make sure that you thoroughly dry everything before storing. Nothing is worse than preparing for a camping trip and discovering either at location if you haven't gone through your inventory list beforehand, or while preparing for it, that your equipment has been damaged. The second item on my list today is removing batteries and store them separately of any electronics before storing. Also, if possible, carry a power bank with you, as well as any cords that you might need to power your different electronic devices. If possible, carry a crank radio to be able to stay ahead of any potential major changes on the weather while you are out. And for those who have filming equipment, do not forget means of cleaning the lenses of your cameras. Uses of dry bags. Everybody knows that dry bags are used to keep important items dry. But did you know that they can also be used for washing clothes? Yep, all you have to do is add water, soap, and your clothes inside of one and shake them thoroughly to loosen the dirt. A pro tip is that for extra thought washing messes, you can add a rock to the bag. Some other people use them just to keep their clean and dirty clothes separated. And there are several uses that are very basic. They just mean putting air inside of them and use them either as a seat, pillow, a kneeling mat, or a flotation device. They can be used for collecting kindling, or they can also be used to transport water from a water source to your camp as a makeshift bear bag, or if you attach a shoulder strap to your dry bag, you can use it as a hiking day bag. And while I have never done this, I have heard of people that use them as a kayak anchor by filling them with sand and rocks, attaching them to a line, the line to the kayak, and letting the bag sink, effectively becoming an anchor. My next topic is Ziploc bags are your friends. Yep. There are many uses outdoors for Ziploc bags that I have experimented with over the years. Anywhere from using them as mag covers to keep my maps protected from water and dew. Also, for travel eggs, you can just pre-mix your eggs and prepare them just in a way that you just have to cut a corner of the bag later on and be ready for cooking the eggs. You can use Ziploc bags to store pre-prepared food in them, particularly marinated meats, for compartmentalization, especially clothes, electricals, and other accessories within your bag. Another use is fly repellent. You can fill a Ziploc bag with water, lime juice, salt, and a couple of copper coins, and set it around your table, and you'll discover how flies are no longer a problem. Where to store your food? The very first thing I can say is away from your sleeping area. That way you can keep animals at night away from you. Some parks and places have metal bear boxes where you can store inside your food and food preparing items. When that is not an option, you can put your food in bear bags and just hang it from higher areas such as trees. If you have a cooler, it's safe to assume that you probably also have a car, so it would be a good idea to keep your cooler day or night inside your car. Yes, it's a little bit hotter, but in places where people go often, animals have become crafty and they have learned how to open coolers, animals like raccoons and bears. Basically, reduce your human sense around your campsite, be it food, toiletry, or food prepping items. Easy to carry with you fire starters. Most people have heard at one point or another that dryer lint is useful to start fires, and indeed it is. I learned this hack myself from my mother-in-law many years ago. But besides that, there's also cotton balls and petroleum jelly or hand sanitizer, especially the ones that have a higher alcohol content. Another one would be wax paper, making little rolls of wax paper with either cotton balls inside or with sawdust. You might be surprised, but in a pinch, the same chips that you eat can also be used as a fire starter. The fattier in content, the better. And last but not least in my list, I would mention duct tape. It's not very easy to set it aflame, but once you get it ignited, it is a very good fire starter. It lasts for a while and produces a very good even flame. Campfire after dark. If you are an avid camper, you probably know this, but there are plenty of people, including myself at some point, that don't know it, and I hope I can help somebody on their first camping trips. Basically, if you are alone, by the time that the sun goes down, your day is over. You should take measures to be able to see as well as you can in the dark. For this reason, keeping a campfire at night is not such a good idea unless you need it for temperature control purposes. Tricks like looking away from the fire so your eyes can accumulate to the low light situation around you, or switching from the campfire to a red or green flashlight if you have one, be it a headlamp or a flashlight, can also help. An important tip I want to share with you guys is prepare before the sun is gone. Along with the campfire after dark, it's important to know that once the light is gone, your ability to prepare for the evening is going to be decreased tenfold. Things like gathering kindle or use the bathroom, put food away from your tent, keep water close to your sleeping area, put out your fire, and secure belongings that won't be inside the tent are very important things to do while you still have light to do them. Don't let sundown catch you unprepared. Staying safe while camping. be aware of where you set your tent. Yes, of course it's important to set it in a flat, rootless place, but people often do not pay attention to what they have on top of their tent. They pick a shady place like where I am walking right now, but forget to check for loose branches that may fall in the middle of the night, or trees that produce an abundant amount of gum. Also, the way that water may drain if there is a flash flood or rain at night. Be aware of the weather, day and night. Try to stay ahead of it and do as much research or keep a radio with you, as I mentioned before. Have a first aid kit, but more important, learn to use it. Any items that you have in your first aid kit that you don't know how to use are just dead weight and are not going to help you or anybody else in an emergency. And speaking of which, stay ahead of potential problems. Things like cell reception, hospital locations, and evacuation routes are very important things that you can research in advance so you are not caught unprepared. Also, keep a map with you at all times. Last thing you want to do is go on a stroll like I'm doing right now and get lost. Keep the wildlife wild. That means try to interact with animals and plants as least as possible. Especially do not feed wild animals, because this changes the way that they act when they encounter other people, and they might get aggressive after expecting getting food from somebody else and not receiving it. Stay safe around campfires. Yes, things like keeping an eye on the wind strength and direction, or your kids if you are not camping alone, or alcohol, not only as a flammable source but also being inebriated can alter your thought process. And last, but by no means least, drive safely. Yes, I know it doesn't sound like an advice for camping, but like you can see right here, most camps have routes that lead to and from them. And even within the camp, there are sections in which you have to drive. And respecting the speed limits and being aware that on any blind turn you can encounter animals is important. So yeah, drive safely. And with this, we're almost back at camp. So I'll leave it to here and meet up with you at the Explorer headquarters.
Well, that was a mouthful. As promised, that was a long video, but I hope that you find information that was useful to you. As I said at the very beginning, there is one bonus subject that I wanted to include. It's all about how to warm up at night. Yes, having a good heat rated sleeping bag is useful, but there are other ways. The sleeping bag doesn't produce heat. It only reflects it, and it helps you to stay warm. But it is ideal to warm up before you even go into your tent. So a little bit of jumping jacks or exercise or sitting by the campfire if you still have it on can help you a lot. Also, it helps to sleep with your socks on and dress up in layers if possible. Hand warmers are also not that expensive, and they come very convenient because you can spread them out in your sleeping arrangements. Also, some people like heating water in a bottle or a canteen, wrap it in clothes and put it at the bottom of the sleeping bag to heat up their feet. This can also be done not only at the feet but in any cold spots of your sleeping bag. It's important to try to use a sleeping pad. Check the heat rating because they vary. Some provide more insulation than others. The same goes for the heat rating of your sleeping bag. Check it against the temperatures that you are expecting for the evening. Well, that's it. I hope you like this video. I'll see you out there. Remember, stay safe, stay outdoors, and leave no trace.